Hi guys, Joseph Hindle here again. I thought I'd do a separate video for the National Youth Theatre because it's quite a different process and institution to drama schools, because it's not a drama school, it's what's largely known as the best alternative to. If you don't know what the National Youth Theatre is, basically it's an organisation that's been around since sort of halfway through the 20th century. I think it was the 50s it was set up. And it's basically where young people from across the country go to train on, say, a two or three week intake course, and then they get what's called National Youth Theatre membership once they graduate said course. And basically what you can do with NYT membership is quite a few things. You can get sort of I think you can get like discounts on tickets and stuff. You've got access to resources, and the main thing which attracts people to it is that once you are in the National Youth Theatre, you have what you call your casting audition that you can do, where you go, you do some monologues and stuff, and what they do is they write a report about you, and then they put you forward for professional work that they're doing, which is where a lot of people can get onto the professional platform without drama school. Just like Helen Mirren did. In fact, she's a strong advocate of the National Youth Theatre, and she said that if it wasn't for the National Youth Theatre, then she probably would not have made it, because drama schools just weren't accepting her and all that lot. And I do feel that drama schools are, well, let's face it, drama school is a very flawed system. It seems to be very elitist. It's very exclusive. It's really hard to get into, but it is without a doubt the best training that any actor can get globally, I think. But the National Youth Theatre is what's often known as the next best thing, and it is a way for people to bypass drama school. I think like David Walliams and Matt Lucas went. I know Matt Smith went. I don't know if any of those went to drama school afterwards. Quite a few people do. But my sister did the intake course last year, so she heavily recommended this to me. And I'm really glad I auditioned for the National Youth Theatre as well as drama schools, because even if I don't get into drama school this year, but I did get into the National Youth Theatre, I would feel content with that, because I do feel like it is great training that just simply no actor can really pass up. You know, it's a great way to move forward without having made the jump to drama school yet, and hopefully not having to make the jump to drama school. I mean, my ideal situation right now would be to get in the National Youth Theatre and Man Met, but that's still a possibility, but let's see. So yeah, the National Youth Theatre audition process is a lot more rigorous than many schools' initial auditions. Like in RADA and Lambda, you just walk in and you go, do your monologue, and then walk out. But with the National Youth Theatre, because they've only got one day to see you before they make a decision about whether you should go on the course or not, they want to get the most out of it. So you do a 3-hour long movement workshop, and then you have an individual audition where you have a little interview, which it really isn't about acting, it's about you. And you also do your speech. You do one speech, doesn't matter what time period it's from, which was very liberating. And you also get to be redirected sometimes. I mean, I don't know about other people, but I'll get more into that in a minute. So basically, when I went to the National Youth Theatre, I had to go and audition in Birmingham because I didn't actually apply early enough to go to Manchester. So basically what happened was I found myself getting up at 4 in the morning to get to the Mac Arts Centre in Birmingham, which is about an hour's walk from Birmingham New Street train station, for 10 o'clock in the morning. Yeah. And I had hardly any sleep that night. I was literally doing that on 2 hours sleep. So imagine that, doing a 3 hour movement workshop and then having to wait 2 hours for your individual audition on 2 hours sleep, so when you've been awake since four. Yeah. But I did it and I feel it went well. I do feel the audition went extremely well. If not maybe my best audition that I've ever done. Because what happened was, the moment I got into the room, the two guys that were running it were just really friendly. Like literally, I can't really place how many people there were. There must have been over 30 people auditioning at the same time. And everyone, and I mean this, like literally every single person in that room was awesome. Like, good at acting and also a great person. Like, they were actually nice, like every single person, which was really, really reassuring because, you know, I was feeling a bit grumpy the night before and everything, but they really did well to ease us into it, and it was really good. Now, what we basically did in the workshop, it was just basically, if anyone's auditioning for the National Youth Theatre and they're worried about what's going to be in the workshop, don't be. It's fun more than anything. You'll forget it's an audition. You actually will. It's just, a lot of it is standing in a circle, playing games with each other. So it's like, we did sort of, I think many of you will know, Zip Zap Boing, that's what it's called, Zip Zap Boing. Except we did a really convoluted version of it, where it was Hep, Boing, Schlack It, and all that lot. And there was this one word called Hack It, where somebody went like that, and then it sent like a big wave all the way to the next person, and that person had to go back it or else they were dead, but you had to judge whether it was you. And that happened to me, and I got it at the last minute, and it was like, I just felt like the king then. I was like, bitch, please. So yeah, a lot of it was just like that. We did this thing where we just sort of had to jump and keep a rhythm going, and then more and more people would jump at the same time. We had just like sort of greeting, sort of name game and everything. And what we also did was, we did, one person would have the energy ball and they would pass it on by clicking. And then we had to get more and more creative, and everyone had to mimic how the person was doing it. And they had to think of creative ways to send the click along, and you had to let that click affect you. And it's just basically just 3 hours of drama based. Well, actually the first 2 hours are drama-based games like that. Just sort of running, jumping, laughing with each other, joking and everything. There's not really much else I can say other than that, if you've done a fun physical workshop before in drama class or something, just think of it as like a longer version of that, because it really is just fun. I remember when the first thing we did though was lie on our backs, close our eyes and just let the nerves flow out. But because I'd only been awake, I'd been awake since four and only had 2 hours sleep, I almost fell asleep. I could feel myself drifting off. I had to sort of pinch myself without the guy noticing, so I was just sort of pinching my leg. I mean, I'd had a Red Bull before, but it just really didn't help. Although, while I was in the actual audition after that point, I didn't feel tired at all. What really made me feel tired was I had to wait 2 hours after the audition, like workshop, to go for my initial audition, which, if I hadn't had people to talk to, I would have fallen asleep. But basically, the final hour of the physical workshop is you split off into groups, you get given some props, and you have to devise a piece of small, like 1.5 minute piece of theatre based on those props. And you've also got to include certain aspects to it, like you have to have a moment of unison where everyone's doing the same thing, you have to have a conflict and a moment of surprise, and you have about 15 minutes to devise that, and then you show them, and then people just There wasn't really feedback given on them, other than the guy did say every group was good. What we did, we were given a coat, a shoe. My mind fails me of what all the other stuff was, but basically, like a pair of headphones or something. And basically, what happened was we decided that Merlin's, for no use of a better word, mentally disabled brother, Derlin, had accidentally shrunk the old woman who lived in a shoe's house, and we had to sort it out. And we had people pissing themselves with laughter. I played Derlin, and I think my northern accent more than anything made people laugh, because the girl came up to me, she's like, "Are you Merlin?" And I was like, "No, I'm Derlin, his brother, wizard college dropout," and everything. And the way the other groups did, like, they did really good stuff as well. Like, they had one of them was a bunch of people were acting like freaking Neanderthals trying to steal a cup of coffee and ritually sacrificing people. You had one where there was a guy who had a bag which looked like what did it look like? It was like a rat or something, and he was on a bus and he thought it was real and everyone was freaked out. And the other one were a bunch of people fighting over bottles and there was like no speaking in it, which I thought was pretty good. It was like very stylized. So everybody did really well. It's like, I couldn't, if you asked me to single out people who based on that workshop are probably gonna get a place on the course, I couldn't tell you. Because one of the shit things about National Youth Theatre is the people who actually audition you don't make the decision. They write a report about you and then send it to the main office and then they decide. Because I know, granted, they've got something like 5,000 people for 500 places, so I suppose there has to be some sort of central nervous system for the whole thing. But I do think they can heavily recommend you, the people who audition you. They can probably write in it, "We heavily recommend this person," and they would probably trust the judgment and give you a place. But I honestly could not single out anybody that was any better than anyone else. Everybody just seemed to be really in sync with each other, and it was just beautiful. Obviously, I didn't see people's initial auditions, people's like individual auditions, because you don't do it in a group; you just do it by yourself. But basically, I went in, and after almost falling asleep for 2 hours, I walked in and said to, I was talking to the student helpers, like, outside, the people who were in the National Youth Theatre, and they were, like, doing a really good job of making me feel comfortable. And I wasn't nervous at all when I went in, because, you know, I'd already gotten to know the auditioner. He was a very nice guy, he had a really relaxing voice. And he asked me if I wanted to do my speech first or do the interview first, and I thought, I'll do my speech first because I'd rather get it out of the way so then I can just do the interview without thinking about the impending performance that should happen. And I did the speech that I'm using as my third speech for my Manchester Metropolitan recall that I've only been doing for about 2 weeks now, and at the time I'd only been doing it for about a week, so it was fresher than my other ones. And I like to think I made a good impression, because it was Konstantin Treplev from The Seagull. I might have mentioned this before, although I have since changed my Konstantin speech. I originally had his first monologue where he's like, "Oh, she loves me, she loves me not," but now I've got the one where he's basically shouting at me and saying, like, "Oh," basically saying, "Stop treating me like shit, why don't you love me anymore? Oh, there's Trigorin, why don't you go suck his dick?" That's basically the gist of it in modern words. And I did it, and my technique, I didn't lose my technique all the way through. I feel like maybe one bad thing was, I think I was turning to the side a bit too much, but he did redirect me twice, and in my experience and what people have told me, redirecting always seems to be a good thing, especially if it's actual redirecting, like, "Okay, now try it like this instead of what you call it, saying, "Oh, can you do it a bit slower?" Because that's not really redirecting, that's just like, "We can't fucking hear you, you're talking too fast." But if somebody says, "Oh, now try it like this," and they tell you to do it in a completely different way, then the way I see it, that means that they're definitely considering you. Because if they weren't considering you, they wouldn't bother redirecting you. They'd go, thank you, and then you're just like, nah, he's shit, fuck off. But if they redirect you, they're like, okay, this person's got potential. Now let's see if they can switch it up a bit. See if they meet the changing demands of the course and see if they can adapt well, because the National Youth Theatre is about directing and working off people. So first he asked me to think about an inner monologue, which I already was doing, but it might not have been too obvious. So, and then he said, like, what, think about verbs. So then I told him the verbs that, like, I was using, and he pretty much agreed with the verbs I'd chosen, except we changed jeer to degrade, which gave it a bit more impact. And then he asked me to do it again, but heavily think of those verbs. And I did that, and I do feel as though the emotion was more authentic that time around. And then he started playing around. He said, okay, now try the speech, which is a pretty gloomy speech. Now try the speech, but as a stand-up comedian, you're in the Apollo, and you're trying to make us laugh about it. And I actually somehow made him laugh. Like, there's a line in it where he says, women never forgive failure. And what he means by that is, it's like, oh, I failed once and now you don't want me, you want Trigorin. But I sort of said it in that weird sort of, like, comedically misogynistic way. Like, I'm not a misogynist, but some comedians get a cheap laugh out of making fun of women. I was like, women never forgive failure, like that, and I had him laughing. So yeah, that went well. Although as I got about halfway through, I was literally losing where I was. I was losing my lines, but he stopped me before that became obvious and said, okay, I've sort of run out of time. So then I had an interview. He asked me about what I'm doing. He seemed genuinely interested about, he said, like, try not to talk about acting and stuff, just what do you do? So I don't really do much other than acting, really. So I started talking about, oh, I'm writing screenplays and stuff like that, and poems and stuff. I draw and do this, do that. I like to direct as well. He seemed generally interested in that. And then the words came out of my mouth. I wasn't going to mention it, but I didn't really have much else to talk about. So I said, I also do political sort of campaigning for my local branch of the political party of my choice. Oh, what political party is that? Oh, great. Labour. And then he nodded and smiled, so I don't know what that means. But he did seem genuinely interested, and I shook his hand after that, and he said it was a pleasure to meet you and everything, and then I walked off and I went. And that was that. And I do think I have a chance. I don't want to get overly optimistic, but I do genuinely think I've got a chance. And I'm not sure which holds more weight. Whether it's the individual audition or the workshop, or whether they hold equal weight. I do feel like if anything would hold more weight, it would be the workshop. Because East 15, God no. I've just done a video about East 15. Still in my brain. National Youth Theatre is very, very physical. So I think how you work with people is maybe slightly more important than your actual acting talent. And I'd like to think I took the redirection well. So I have often been told by directors that I am very good at taking critique on board, which you've got to be, really, haven't you? So I do genuinely think I have a chance. And if you're auditioning for the NYT, good on you. It's a great thing to do because it's a good alternative. It won't, you know, it's in August, so, you know, even if you get in a drama school, you can do both, provided you can afford it, really. And I've forgotten how much it is. It's like 600 quid or something, but, like, it does seem genuinely worth it, and I feel optimistic. I do. So auditions I've got left now are just Lambda initial again, and my Manchester Metropolitan recall. It's whittling down now. Although I do feel optimistic about Manchester. Very optimistic. Because from what I've heard of how they do recalls, I feel like I could do that well. But that's for another video. I'm waffling again. Thank you very much for watching. Peace.